Happy Sabbath, brothers and sisters. Our speaker is a friend of mine. He is new. You will get to know him more. He's also a licensed BSECE, and he owns, he runs, God has blessed him with so many things, so many experiences. I just want you to know he is a man of God. The Spirit of the Lord is with this man. You will, if there is a description about true Christianity, simple, very real life, down-to-earth, humble Christianity, you will listen it from Brother Albert Arellano. May the Lord be with him as he speaks, and may we understand and maybe become like more Jesus as we listen to his testimony.
Happy Sabbath, everybody.
Sabbath.
Forgive me, a while ago, I didn't notice that we need to speak English here. So, the Lord have spoken to me that many intelligent people are to be in this place today. Amen. And you have all the wisdom to help the Word of God be propagated and the Kingdom of God be expanded through each and every one of you. So, God bless and happy Sabbath to everybody. May I say happy Sabbath?
Happy Sabbath.
Not everybody may be happy. You must, we must always show our smile for us to show the world that we have the fruit of the Holy Spirit. And that is love, peace, joy, patience, and many others. Amen?
Amen.
So if we have joy, then we can say that. So, okay. All right, I've been a born Catholic, and I become a member of the Jesus is Lord Church for more than 20 years. And after being a member of the Jesus is Lord Church, I was blessed by the Lord and become a member of the Gideon's International in the Philippines. Do you know that Gideon's International in the Philippines? Those group that are giving Bibles to the students in all the in all schools, and putting Bibles in the hospitals and hotels. Yeah. So I was led by the Holy Spirit, and now I become a Seventh-day Adventist Christian. Amen. So being a born-again Christian, being a part of the Seventh-day Adventist, I have been, I've given a chance to be invited with the program Pag-aralan Natin in the Facebook. We normally have this live during Thursdays. Okay. So, well, that's my name. And I can say that I am not a Seventh-day Adventist. By birth, I am not a Seventh-day Adventist, but by choice, I am now a Seventh-day Adventist Christian.
Amen.
So, will you accept, ma'am? So, when I was a Catholic, I lived like a Catholic, baptized, became a Catholic, and prayed the rosary, and the priest, the father, and Mary is the mother of God. And when I was a Catholic, we also eat this. Crabs, lobsters, oysters, and even this. Have you tasted this? And also this one. This is cockroach in the land. But we eat this before, the cockroach in the sea. So it does. So what I noticed before, that we are eating this, but we are becoming sick. It's because of the truth of the Lord in the Bible that these are scavengers. These are not given for food. So if it's not given for food, then it is not a food to eat. Amen?
Amen.
So when I was a Catholic, I also been a member of this ABS-CBN. Wine, ladies, the cabaret, or the red houses. So I've been in this kind of vices. And when I was high school, I was given this small Bible from the Gideon's International. And when I was college, but because my interest before is not of the Lord, my interest is of this world. So that I cannot put my interest to read even the Bible, this Bible. So if your interest is only of this world, you will never have an interest to meet the Lord, to read the Bible. That's why I didn't even read this Bible when I was in high school. So, when I was college, I've been even a member of this program in the TV, and I've been become a vocalist of one of the band of the Shakey's Parlor, singing at the Shakey's Parlor with our group. But one time, the nephew of Meli Tagasa, the director of this school Bukul, the nephew was about to go somewhere else, and he said, "Albert, come and join me for a ride. Are you going home?" And I said, "Yes." So I need to go with him, and then he dropped me at Ligayas. But since this is a Mercedes-Benz, of course, it's very attractive to bad people. And there's a jeepney rushing by, and then he said, pasig. So I went, I went in and then ride the jeepney going to Pasig. And then on the other side of the road, there's another guy who ride also. But not far away, this other guy jumped off. Oh, I was so surprised. Why? So so far away, it is dark, and then so suddenly, the four guys on the four corners of the jeepney, they declared, "Hold up, ito!" And then they stabbed me by my hips, and I said, "Oh!" And then they pushed me. They said, "Oh, you go nearby the exit." And then while we are going by the exit, I am holding by the rail, and then they are stabbing me, my body, and taking all my things, my watch, my ring, my wallet, and my shoes. It's good that they did not take off my pants. So they dragged me, and then they pushed me, and then they pushed me out, and then. What the first thing I felt, I am standing. I checked my body like this. And then I saw, oh, there's no blood. You know why? There is a white, powerful light on top of me while they are stabbing me. And then the word that I know that I said, "Please help me, whoever you are." And I said, when there is no blood, I said, "Praise God. Thank you, Lord, you have saved me." So there's a taxi. I saw a light. It's a taxi. I ride it on. And then when I went home, my mother opened the gate. When he opened the gate, he said, "Oh, what drama again is that, my son?" Because she saw stabs, but there's no blood. Footprints on my dress. But when he looked down, he saw the... My blood oozing on my hips. And she said, "Okay, you go. Help yourself. Fix yourself. And then you rest. I'll be the one to do something to pay the taxi." So while in my room, I felt so hot. And there's something I've been looking for something else. And you know what? I saw this little Bible again. And then I get it. And when I opened it, I opened it in the book of John. And I read like this: "In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was with God in the beginning. Through Him all things were made. Without Him nothing was made that has been made. And in Him was life, and that life was the light of man." So I felt like this light over me, the power over me, had been introducing himself to me. So I read and read and read. Even in what he said in the book of John chapter 1 verse 12, but as many as received him, to them gave the power to become the Son of God. Not every created man and woman are sons and daughters of God, but only to those who receive him. So I felt that something is in this Bible. And also, the Word was made flesh, so it confirms that it is the Son of God who have helped me, who have saved me, and he loved me. So I can say that I was not saved by a church. I read from that book of John up to the Revelation. And then there at the back of the Bible, there's an invitation to receive Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior. So what I did is, I read that back of the Bible, and it says that he loved me very much. For God so loved the world, that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believe in him, whosoever, even though you are Filipino, if you are Indian, black, white, or whatever color you are, whosoever believe in him will not perish but have everlasting life. So I said, Lord, thank you for loving me. And it says also there that all have sinned and fall short to the glory of God. And the wages of sin is death. But the gift of God is Jesus Christ who gave us salvation. So, I have been saved and belong, not belonging to a church, but I have been born again. Because he said in John chapter 3 verse 3, unless a man be born again, he cannot see the kingdom of God. Who have seen, who among you here have seen the kingdom of God? Can you even just raise your hand a little? Have you seen the kingdom of God? Have we seen the kingdom of God? And he continued in chapter 5. Unless a man be born of water and of the Spirit, he cannot enter the kingdom of God. If I cannot even see the kingdom of God, how then I can enter the kingdom of God? Who among you are being baptized with water? So can you raise your hand? Oh, you must be proud. You must do like this. You must be proud that you've been born of water. You've been baptized with water. No? If not, then it is timely that you must be born with water. I would like to urge each and everyone, if you have not been baptized with water, it is about time that we must repent our sins and accept Jesus Christ as our Lord and Savior and be baptized, be cleansed, declare that you are of God. And who among you are baptized with the Holy Spirit? Who among us here are baptized with the Holy Spirit? No. Why? Maybe you don't know. What I will tell you, if you are baptized with the Holy Spirit. Because when we are baptized by our pastors, he said, I baptize you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Maybe when you are baptized, you accept only the Father. Maybe when you are baptized, you accept only the Son, but you forgot the Holy Spirit. We must be baptized by the Holy Spirit. How do we know that the Holy Spirit is in us? If we have the fruit of the Holy Spirit in us. Amen? Amen. If you love, if you have patience, you have long-suffering, you have faithfulness, all of this we must memorize to show the world that we are His Son. Amen? So, Also, it says in the book of Ephesians chapter 2, verse 8, 10, for the by grace you have been saved through faith. Maybe each and every one of us know about grace. What is grace? This is the free gift of salvation, that it is free. We just need to accept it. Amen? If we don't accept this free gift of salvation, how then can we be saved? And it is by faith that you can accept and receive this gift. And no other than the gift of salvation is Jesus Christ. How are we going to accept and receive Jesus Christ? Have you received Jesus Christ? Have you accepted Jesus Christ? How do you know? How do we know that we received Jesus Christ? Of course, as said in the Bible, in the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. And on verse 14 it says, and the Word became flesh. So, if we accept the Word of God and put it in our heart and make this alive in us, then we have accepted Jesus Christ as our Lord and Savior. Amen? So, if we did not accept Him, how do we accept Him? It is by accepting the Word and put in our heart and make this alive through the Holy Spirit. So, becoming a Christian, God blessed me. Now, I become a businessman. Because the Lord said, for I know the plans I have for you, declares the Lord. Plans to prosper you and not to harm you. Plans to give you hope and the future. Then you will call in my name and come and pray to me, and I will listen to you. So it is very important, brothers and sisters, if you have not yet received Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior, these words of God, this word of God, will not be alive in you. The only way that the Lord, the word of God, be alive in you is by accepting Jesus Christ as our Lord and Savior. My story, me and my wife's story, started when we are selling barbecue on the street. Fishbowl, turon, and many others, palami. Or cold drinks on the street. Early in the morning, we go to the market, 3 o'clock. We buy pork because we are not yet Adventist before. We buy pork early in the morning. We go to, when we come home, we prepare it. After preparing it, I go to Divisoria. And then I will buy fishbowl. Now, I saw how they make fishbowl. They have this arena or starch, and then with betchin, the fish they use is shark. Shark. They cannot put an expensive fish in this fishbowl. And I learned when I become a Seventh-day Adventist, I researched that the Lord have given those fish that have scales and fins. Because if the moment that you are to catch this fish, it will it has the capacity or capability to remove the toxins, the poisons, and the heavy metal in it. But those fish without the scales and fins don't have the ability. So what we are eating when we eat fishbowl is full of toxins and heavy metals. So even the the cream dory, cream dory here. Before I don't know that cream dory is a scavenger. the food that is the cream during it is a dead rats and dead fish. Even you, when you die, you can be even eaten by the cream dory. So before I eat a lot of this, but there was one time that I bought a DVD when coming from Divisoria, and I have this playing very loud. But when the moment that a song came like this, "Come Holy Spirit, I need you. Come Holy Spirit, I pray." So I felt a presence of the Holy Spirit. And you know what? I knelt down. Because our house before is barong-barong. You know barong-barong? A temporary house. And then this is a land without house. And I've been planting vegetables. And so that moment when I pray, the Holy Spirit leads me to pray like this. "Father, let me have this land. Give me this land, O God. Today, I thank you that this land will be mine. Thank you, O Lord." Imagine the Holy Spirit have led me to pray like this. And then after some time, you know, selling barbecue on the street, one of my compadre came over and then he told me, "Oh, Brother Albert, why are you selling barbecue? It's not that good for you. You are an engineer. But you have to live like engineer." I said, "No, you try my barbecue. It's very good." And he tried. And then he told me, "But it's not good for you to be selling barbecue. I will introduce you to my friend." Then the Lord came into my mind. I said, "Lord, this must be your answer." So I went to that company, and then you know what? That place is very small. It's just from here to here up to there, and there's only one whiteboard with three projects written on it. Only three projects. And I said, "Lord, if this is your will to work in this company, be it, O Lord, but bless me." So I was accepted, and then you know when. The first project that I made, I asked the Lord, "Lord, give me this project. Anything that I can get out of this, I will give it to you." So, you know what? This project becomes an order. So, I was blessed with one order, and then another order, and another order. And you know what? After 2 months, that whiteboard was filled with so many projects. And only a name, Albert, was there. I am so blessed by the Lord. So Lord, thank you very much. You know what? Before, if I go out to meet a customer, I have a attache case. And you know what is inside the attache case? Rice. With salted egg. And it's good enough if my wife can put in salty egg and tuyo. What is tuyo?
Dried fish.
So it will be my joy, you know. But you know what? After 2 months, after 2 years, the Lord have blessed me with so many orders, and I got my first commission. My first commission, I did not think of it, but I just take it, and then went to the bank, and then the bank said, "Do you have anything for us to put your money?" And I said, "Yes." And then when I opened it, they saw my baon, the rice. I'm sorry. So they took the attache case, and then, you know what, when they returned it, it is full of money. And I'm, "Lord, thank you very much." So I went to Makati, roaming around and looking for a bank to deposit it, but nobody wants to accept it. Why? because they thought that I robbed a bank or did something wrong to get the money. You know? That, but there's one bank that accepted, and I signed a waiver, and they counted it and put it in the bank book. So I have my suitcase, and you know, after some time, my uncle called me. He said, "Albert, do you want to buy my land?" "Oh, no, uncle, maybe it's so expensive, maybe I cannot afford it." So my uncle said, "I am sick, I need the money. So I just sell it to you for a cheap price." And then, okay. So my wife heard about this. And then maybe she opened my suitcase and then took my bank book. And then she went to the bank and then updated. You know what? What is inside the bank book? It's enough, not just enough to buy the land, but to put up a bungalow house and to buy our own car. Amen? Praise God. Amen. So I praise him. Then also while working in that company, I happened to make a project. So this project is about, you are electronic engineers. All of you are electronic engineers? Or some of you? Okay, this is just to show you how good the Lord is. So I make a project, and that is about, if you have, you know, thermocouples or sensors? So if you have sensors for for a machine with coils, then you have six sensors. And this device will output a signal to whichever is the highest from all the six. So it will select. It will select. So our customer have tried many companies, and nobody can supply it. And then it came to me. "Albert, can you do this?" "Oh, yes. Because I have my God. I have the Lord with me. I'm talking myself. I have my God. I can do this." So, okay, you make up a quotation. So I made the project. And then write it like this. "Lord, help me. Lord, help me." And you know what? I came up with a project. The cost is 14 million pesos. So I submitted, and then, well, when it become an order, they ordered the 14 million project just because of this design that I made. You know, when you make a design, whatever you do, do it always for the glory of God. Amen? Whenever you think of something else, whenever you study something else, do it all for the glory of God, and He will bless you. So, I was blessed, but when my boss came, he said, "Albert, we have an order, but I will not give it to you first." "Why?" "I will give it to Yokogawa. The Japanese knows it well than you." He said, "Okay, but it hurts me a little bit, but..." I said, "It's okay." So after 1 month, Yokogawa came. Okay. And he said, "Sorry, we cannot do it." So he bring the project design to other countries like Singapore. But they say no. To US, they say no. To Hong Kong, they say no. To the Philippines, to other electronic companies here, they said no. "We cannot do it." And then my boss said, "Oh, Albert, suko na ako." So he said, "Okay, we make a contract, you do it. Because you are the one who designed it, you can do it, I believe. But we must sign a contract. That if you cannot do it, I will put you to jail." So, you know, 3 months. So 2 months I've been trying to put the... open op arms. Who among you are familiar with op arms? So this signal of sinusoidal then converted to like this trapezoid or whatever signal that you want. So I designed this like this, and then put it into two parts. So, okay, but whenever I turn it on, it won't work. So every time that I do the design again and again, it won't work. So my boss came 1 month before the deadline. He said, "Oh, Albert, why is it that the parts are still here? What are you doing? Are you sleeping?" I tell you, if you cannot do it within this month, I will put you to jail. I will sue you. He said, and I said, "Okay, boss, I can do it. I can do it." But you know what? I tried daily to make the circuit. But, you know, there was one night I said, "Lord, I think I forgot you. I forgot you. Forgive me, O Lord. But Lord, tonight, make me sleep and put this in my dream. Whatever the solution is, whatever the correct circuit is, please put it in my dream." You know, I lean on the small sofa, and then, you know, I get sleep, and then I've been dreaming. I put some parts like this, I know these parts, and then I put it together. You know, when I turn it on, it works. And then, you know what, I said, "Hallelujah, praise the Lord!" And I wake up. I'm dreaming. But you know what? By faith, I put these parts in my list, and all the parts that I need, I went to Raon, the electronic shops, and I bought it all. And then when I went home, I just fixed myself and then tried it. I put these parts all together, and then as I finish it, I turn it on, and you know what? It works. And I said, "Hallelujah! Praise the Lord! It works!" So, that dream came true. Because the Lord said, in Acts chapter 2 verse 17, "And in the last days it shall be, God declares, that I will pour out my spirit in all flesh, and your sons and daughters shall prophesy. And your sons and daughters shall prophesy, and your young men shall see visions, and your old men shall dream dreams." So even in these last days, the Lord is communicating with us through visions and dreams. Amen? Amen. So if you pray, you must always have this vision. Communicate with the Lord by your vision, and He will know what exactly you need, and He will answer you, give you the solution. And also, if you cannot get the solution in that request, in that prayer, do it in dreams. Amen. So even in the old times, Daniel got the dream of the king Nebuchadnezzar by a dream. That's why there is a word dream, because this is used by the Lord, by the Holy Spirit, to commune with Him, with our God. Amen? So you know what happened? After my wife became my technician, I'm the engineer, my wife, my technician, and my brother-in-law is another technician, and putting all together, and we submitted and delivered it on time. And then they paid it, 14 million. And you know what happened? They repeat order, 14 million. Imagine, God is so great. Huh? So, it's very nice if you want anything to happen to you. I give you the secret, so that the Lord will answer you. it says like this. The Lord said like this, if you abide in me, and my words abide in you, ask whatever you wish, and it shall be given to you. Amen?
Amen.
How can you abide in him? How? It is by subjecting yourself, following the Lord, following all his commandments. Amen? And how can his word abide in us? If this word that we have accepted, ask the Holy Spirit to make it alive in us, and it will become alive. It will become a wisdom. You know the difference between the knowledge and the wisdom? The knowledge is you learn things by this, but you don't want to do it. But you know what is wisdom? Wisdom is the same knowledge that you got, but you do it because the Lord said, faith without work is dead. Amen? Faith without work is dead. Are you dead? No. We are all alive in Jesus. Amen? So we are blessed by the Lord. Being a member of the Jesus is Lord Church, I became a member of Jesus is Lord Church. And then we become a lifetime member because we are businessmen of the Gideon's International in the Philippines. Our aim is to share the saving knowledge of our Lord Jesus Christ. We give the Bible. In this place, we have provided or shared the gospel to this school, the workers, the teachers, and all, even the students. More than 2,000 souls have accepted Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior. And here, the students like it very much. They are thirst with the word. How come that when we grow up, we don't even, we make the word of God our sleeping pills? So, as a member of the Jesus is Lord, you know, and we become a Gideon's International member, a lifetime member, but now we are no longer member of the Gideon's International. Why? Because the Gideon's International, they say that the Seventh-day Adventist is a cult. You know, I will tell you later. So, we went to some, just like, you know, in the penitentiary, we went there, we shared the gospel. More than 12,000 souls in the inmates, 12,000 inmates have received the Bible. But you know what happened after they received the Bible? After 2 months, all those syndicates happening in the penitentiary was revealed. Even up to now, those people that are involved are being put to jail. All these drugs, you know, the weapon, and also prostitution and everything were revealed. You know why? The Word of God is really alive. It is not just ink or pen. It is even greater than two-edged sword, that it can put division between the soul and the spirit, and the bone and the marrow, and it can even reveal what is in our heart. That's why the Word of God is really alive. It must not be taken for granted. The Word of God become flesh, and that is Jesus Christ. Amen?
Amen.
When he died, did he become dead until now? No, he is alive. Amen? So being in this Gideon's and Jesus Lord Church, I've been bothered. I was very, there is something bothering me. You know what? Because when I was with the Jesus Lord Church more than 20 years, we are, we call Sunday keepers. In Tagalog, linguista. No? They call us linguista, Sunday keepers. when we are in the Jesus Lord Church. All Gideon's members are churches that are worshiping, keeping the Lord's Day on the Sunday. The evangelical and Protestant, those are the only churches that are accepted to become Gideons. But I've been invited because I've been reading the Bible, and you know what? I read in the Bible like this. In Revelations, this one. Blessed are those who do His commandments, that they may have the right to the tree of life and may enter through the gates into the city. Do His commandments. And I said also, if you love me, keep my commandments. He that said, I know him, and keep it not his commandment, is a liar, and the truth is not in him. I heard one time, one of our pastors said, we don't need the 10 commandments anymore. We need only the 2 commandments. But how can we show how can we follow the 2 commandments when you said, yeah, love God with all your heart, with all your soul, with your spirit? Are we going to make a golden calf and then worship God? That is not right. So to be right in worshiping the Lord, in loving the Lord, we must know the 10 commandments. Amen? Like the 10 commandments, it said, thou shalt not make any graven image in any likeness in heaven above, in the earth below, and underneath the sea. Thou shalt not bow down to them or serve them, for I am the Lord thy God. I am a jealous God. So, when you say that you know Him, but keep it not His commandment. And also, the Lord loved us very much. As said in John chapter 3, verse 16, for God so loved the world, that He gave His only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in Him will not perish, but have everlasting life. He loved us even we have sinned and fall short to His glory. And the wages of sin is death, but He loved us very much. And He wants us to have an everlasting life. But what shall we do then if we are saved by the Lord? What are we going to do in return? It says in John chapter 14, verse 21, that he who has my commandments and obeys them, he is the one who loved me. He who loved me will be loved by my Father, and I too will love him, and I will show myself to him. Any one of you here have seen the Lord? Have he shown himself to you? I tell you, if you will obey him, not even Noah was saved by grace. He was saved by obedience. It's like this. It says that by grace, you have been saved by faith. So you are a sinner. Then you have received Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior. And you have received this gift of salvation. You are saved. But after you've been saved, what are you going to do? Are you going to disobey? You have to walk straight in obedience to the Lord until His second coming. Amen?
Amen.
If you will disobey, I tell you, if you have disobeyed one of the law, you have disobeyed all of it. I give you an example. If you commit adultery, then you don't want this to be known by your wife. And what will you do? So you have committed adultery, then you will lie. Because you don't want your wife to know about this. And then, after when somebody saw you, what are you going to do? Oh, don't tell this to my wife or I'll kill you. Then when he says so, you will destroy him. Say something like character assassination. Yeah? Then you have killed. Then later on, you will not even have the courage to kneel down and ask forgiveness to the Lord. Then what will happen to you? You will die. So, it is by obedience. After salvation, it is by obedience. that we will be saved. Amen? But, you know, our pastor, Brother Eddie Villanueva, once told us, he read the Ten Commandments, and when he came to the Fourth Commandment, he said, remember the Sabbath day to keep it holy. 6 days that you will work, but on the seventh day, you shall rest. But he said, turning his word back, he said, but the Sabbath today is no longer Saturday, but Sunday. Wow. He said, what? And then, you know, he said like this, that it is now Sunday because most of the works and the industries and the businesses stop and rest during Sunday. Imagine what kind of pastor, leader of that worldwide network of worshiping the Lord and saying, you know, that Sabbath day is not anymore Saturday, but Sunday. He is making his own wrong path. So, I am so glad, you know, to learn about the Seventh-day Adventist. Because, just like the Lord said, not everyone who says to me, Lord, Lord, shall enter the kingdom of heaven, but he who does the will of my Father in heaven. Brother Eddie, sometimes, telling something like this, everybody is worshiping. It's raining. And then the Brother Eddie said, rain, I command you in Jesus' name to get out. You know what? After 3 minutes, the rain was done. And everybody's umbrella was folded, unfolded. And then I was surprised and I said, oh Lord, you are here. That's why I became a Jesus, member of the Jesus is Lord Church. And then the program is Jesus the Healer. Everybody is asking for healing, and they were healed. But the Lord said it's like this. Many will say to me on that day, Lord, Lord, have you not prophesied in your name? Cast out demons in your name, and done many wonders in your name. And the Lord said in 23, and then I will declare to them, I never knew you. You depart from me. You who practice lawlessness, doing something against the law, lawlessness. So, those verses make me feel like I like to go out of this religion, of this Jesus is Lord. And there was one time a pastor of GIL from Israel. He preached on the in the congregation, and he said, "Oh, you, all of us Filipinos, we are so stubborn. Just because that we have our maintenance medicine, then we ought to eat as this passport to eat pork." And many other forbidden foods in the Bible. We must do the principle of eating in the Bible. Oh, this is very nice, I said. So after his preaching, I asked him outside. And I asked him, "Hey, Pastor, it's very nice that you have teach us about the principle of eating. And what about in Israel? Do you do this? Are you not eating pork, lobster? And many other things." "Oh yeah, in Israel, we don't eat all of this. We don't eat this forbidden food in the Bible." "And what about," and I said, "what about here in Philippines? We are eating a lot of this pork." And he said, "I don't know. I don't know what kind of, the leadership are doing." And then I asked him, "what about the principle of resting?" "Yeah, yes. Friday sundown to Saturday sundown, we stop our work. We prepare ourselves to worship the Lord." "Oh," I said, "good. And we are doing the principle of rest." And I here in Philippines. Why is it that our worship is Sunday? As I don't know. So, this is the pastor from Israel. So, I search. You know where to search? Nowadays, when you search, you go to the internet, right? It's because I want to find a religion or a church that worship on Saturday. So I went to the internet and I looked for a church. And you know what? I found Seventh-day Adventist. But you know what? There is a little word afterwards. It says cult. So I didn't mind it. So I looked for other churches, but I found nothing. Then I went back. I searched even in the YouTube and more in the internet. And it says, cult. But it's good that the Lord have led me to the official website of Seventh-day Adventist. And I found the 28 fundamental beliefs of Seventh-day Adventist. And I asked the Lord, thank you, Lord, but you know, but I want to read this. If I found something else that can say that Seventh-day Adventist is a cult, I will never be part of it. So I knelt down, I read the Bible, I read the 28 fundamental beliefs, and you know what? I found nothing. Not even one to say that the Seventh-day Adventist is a cult. Amen?
Amen.
So it is not a cult. Now my question is, have you read the 28 fundamental beliefs of Seventh-day Adventists? Who among you have read it? Who can be proud enough to say that I have read it? You know what, brothers and sisters, my friends? We must be founded right. And that foundation must be the 28 fundamental beliefs of Seventh-day Adventists. If we are professing and practicing Seventh-day Adventists, we must be founded with the right foundation. And that is the fundamental belief of Seventh-day Adventists. Amen? Because if somebody teaches you another truth, then you might be misled. You might go away and you will say, Seventh-day Adventist is a cult. It is not right. So, I've been watching TV, and there is Brother Ted Wilson in Channel 55, 45, 9 o'clock in the evening, and he is preaching. Oh, some of my answers are being, some of my questions are being answered. So I praise the Lord on that. And there's another program, and that is Capitulo Versiculo. And so I watch, and then I learn. Many of my questions are answered. And I was so surprised that I've been in love. And I asked one of the speaker, and I asked him one of the questions that is in my heart. The very question, very long ago, I want to know. And then, just a short answer, I said, brother, take me. I want to be a Seventh-day Adventist.
Amen.
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 But that program, I've been become part of it in the form of another program in Facebook called the Pag-aralan Natin. So, me and my wife, after several studies, Bible studies at home, me, my wife, and others, six others, were baptized last March 5. 2016.
Wow.
So March 5. So, can you accept us as your brothers and sisters?
Yes.
Amen. So now, I've been being a guest speaker of this program in the Facebook, Pag-aralan Natin. And you know, one of the things that I always want to do when I receive a news is to share it. Then I went to my father and I shared it. I said to my father, Dad, I no longer worship on Sunday because we are no longer a member of Jesus is Lord, but we are already baptized in the Seventh-day Adventist and we worship only Saturday. And my father said, oh, to me, if I put Wednesday as my the Lord, to worship the Lord on Wednesday, it is the Sabbath for me. He said, and I said, Pa, that if you set Wednesday as your Sabbath, who set it and made it holy? It's me. So I shared him the word from Genesis chapter 2 verse 1 to 3, and that it said after he created the heaven and the earth, he rested in the seventh day and blessed it and made it holy. That it says it also in the Exodus chapter 20 verse 8, remember the Sabbath to keep it holy. 6 days that you will work. And it, because we are Ilocanos, Sabbath is Sabado. It's not Linggo. So, Sabado. And then you know what he did? He went to his pastor. And then, Pastor, why is it that it is written here that we must worship the Lord every Saturday, not Sunday? But why is it that we are worshiping on Sunday? You know what's the answer of the pastor? Because it is not in our doctrine. Imagine pastors, big evangelical churches, they answer it like this. It is not in our doctrine. They are making their own doctrine out of the book of life, out of the book, out of the Bible. Imagine, can you put yourself into that kind of religion which is a blaspheme unto the Lord? So we even talk about the food. My father said, oh, the food, if you take it in, when it get out, it becomes clean. So I said, Dad, maybe you have read it a little short. Maybe we have to read, start it from the beginning, from chapter, from verse 1. And then when we read it, he found out that it is not a pork or even a forbidden food, but it is a bread that was contaminated with dirt. That when you eat it, it cannot, it can be clean. So he went again to his pastor. Pastor, why is it that it is written here we must not eat pork? Why is it that we eat pork? And you know what his answer is? It is not in our doctrine. Imagine. So if you add or subtract in this word of the Lord, you will be cursed. So my father was a little bit enlightened. So these are the three, not because why now I am a Seventh-day Adventist. I am a Seventh-day Adventist not because the church is perfect. No church in this world is perfect. Not even the evangelical, Protestant, or born-again churches. Not even Seventh-day Adventist church is perfect. Because you know what? Because inside the church, there are good and bad. And there are weeds and good seed. And there are sheep and goats. Who want to be a sheep? Yeah. So we must be a sheep. Do you know what is a sheep is? And a goat is? You know, if the Lord said, all things that you do to these little ones, you do it for me. I thirst, and you give me drink. I hunger, and you give me food. I've been from other country, and you take me in. And that is the sheep. And what is the goat? I thirst, you don't even give me drink. I hunger, you don't even give me food to eat. And that is the sheep. Now, we must all be sheep. And we must not judge the other sheep on the other religions or other faiths. Because the Lord said there are other sheep that in other shepherd that I will bring them also into this sheep. So the Lord, you know, just like me, maybe I am one of the sheep from other religion. And he brought me into this chapter. So we've been invited in many other places, and becoming a Seventh-day Adventist, we no longer eat this. Yeah, that's why. So we must be wise as the serpent, because nowadays foods are being commercialized, and they put something to make it beautiful and attractive and tasty with forks and many other things. So I'm sorry to say, I like to beg you to not to become pork eaters. So next, please. So I've been a Seventh-day Adventist because of the Ten Commandments, not because of just following the Nine Commandments. Okay, can you advance, please? And I've been a Seventh-day Adventist because the Ten Commandments is the character of God. The Lord is holy, and the Ten Commandments is holy. Also, I've been a Seventh-day Adventist because of the seventh-day Sabbath. Because the seventh-day Sabbath is very important to each and every creation. Now, this is the day of rest, and this is the day of test. You know why I said it's the day of test? Every time that Sabbath will come, we must always test ourselves. Just like, you know, how are you going to know if there's something on your face? You look at the mirror, and then if there's something on your face, what are you going to do? Are you going to take the mirror and like this? No, of course not. You will take water to wash it. The same as if we have sinned, we must put the Ten Commandments as our mirror. And if there's something that we have not followed, and we have sinned, we must ask forgiveness to the Lord and be cleansed. And what are we going, what does the Lord will do to cleanse us? By the blood of Jesus. The blood of Jesus cleanses us. Amen. And also, I became a Seventh-day Adventist. Can you forward another one? So I became a Seventh-day Adventist because we believe in the whole gospel. When I was about to say goodbye to the Gideon's International, because I've been a president and a director, the regional director of the Gideon's International. And after our regional meeting, I said, sorry, I need to say goodbye, because I am now a Seventh-day Adventist, baptized, and I know that in our guidebook, Seventh-day Adventists are not accepted as even a member. So, you know, one of the members said, oh, why Seventh-day Adventist? It is a cult, isn't it? You have another book that is, who is that? White, Ellen G. White. I told him, you know what? I read some of the book of Ellen G. White. And Ellen G. White herself said that the only basis of our teachings and doctrines must always be the Bible, and the Bible alone. Sola Scriptura. And you know what? He said, okay. But the other guy said, oh, the Seventh Adventist is fault because they are Arianism. I said, no, I know Arianism. Arianism is when you believe that Jesus Christ is not God. So if you believe only that Jesus Christ is a man, but in the Seventh-day Adventist we believe that Jesus Christ is God, and God become man, so he's man. So they stop. And then the higher official said, he researched in the Wikipedia, and he said, oh, the Seventh-day Adventist is no longer a cult. He said, oh, why? I don't know that. I said, It says here that the Seventh Day Adventist is a real Protestant because they don't follow or protest against the teaching of the Catholic. And they are also evangelical because they evangelize and share the saving knowledge of our Lord Jesus Christ. And you know, so everybody was happy, but still, they cannot accept us because of the guidebook. It happens. So, but I believe that the Seventh Adventist is teaching the full gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen? So I also became a Seventh Adventist because of the doctrine of Trinity. Who among you don't believe in the Trinity? Who among you believes in the Trinity of the Seventh Adventist? Only few. Maybe you don't know. When I searched the Trinity, in the Catholic, it says the Trinity is the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. And then in the Seventh Adventist, it says also the Trinity is the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Are there any difference? Can you see any difference? I see very big difference. In the Catholic, the Father is the Pope. But in the Seventh-day Adventist, the Father is our Father in heaven. Amen? So in that sense, even their Son, the Son that they are saying, is not even Jesus Christ. And the Holy Spirit is another spirit that is in them. So that is the big difference. So I believe in the doctrine of Trinity. So you must read the 28 fundamental beliefs of Seventh-day Adventist. And you can see there the teachings and the belief about the Trinity. So another thing is I became a Seventh-day Adventist because the Seventh-day Adventist is the fulfillment of the New Testament. I will not go further on that. Just read. And then the last is like this. Life is sure. Death is sure. Sin, the cause. Christ, the cure. So I tell you, brothers and sisters, let us share Jesus Christ, our Lord. And let us not be ashamed to share our faith. Maybe you've been 10 years as Seventh-day Adventist. Maybe you are 5 years, 3 years as Seventh-day Adventist. What is Adventist? This is the second coming. We are waiting for the second coming. The Adventists are waiting for the second coming of our Lord Jesus Christ. Then while we are waiting, what are we going to do? What are we going to do? We must prepare. We must be prepared. Maybe when the Lord comes, we are asleep. So we must always do the right thing to prepare. I was so blessed by this picture. More than 100,000 souls were baptized. Here in Philippines, when we make crusade, maybe hundreds are being baptized. But after a week or two, this 100 become only 10. Why? Why? So we spend a lot of money getting these 100 people. Maybe because we get them from the work yard where they can work Saturday. But after taking them out of that work yard, there is no place that we can put them. No work. Imagine. So, I remember the time that the Lord had blessed us when I was in Jesus is Lord Church. We made a club named GIL, Business Club, gathering all businessmen and professionals and putting all our resources to put up new business and to make work for all those members that have no work. Is that good? Amen? So, it is nice that maybe someday we can also have SDA, Business Club. Amen? And lastly, this one. We, the Lord said, it is saying here that we must bear fruit. Like the tree. We must bear fruit. Very big. But the Lord is saying it is grapes, no? Vineyard. Have you seen a vineyard with only one fruit? A grape with only one fruit? Is it nice to see? A grape fruit. And then also, what about banana? Can you imagine a banana with only one fruit? Then the Lord would want us to bear fruit. If we have sins in our heart, maybe we have struggles in our life, ask the Lord to cleanse us so that we can bear fruit. So, it is nice to be with the Lord always. And He wants us to bear fruit 30, or not, even if not 30, 50, if not 50, 100. How many fruits that you already have? Have you brought even one soul in the church? Have you brought your brother or your mother? Have you invited them to come to church? Your friends, your best friends? Are we an Adventist only? We must be an Adventist bearing fruits. Maybe we are asking, I've been an Adventist for more than 20 years. I've been waiting for the Lord to come. But why is it that He did not come yet? Why? Maybe the reason is you. We are confident already that we are Adventist. And we have already been saved. And we can be in heaven with the Lord. But what about our friends? What about our father, our mother? What about our brothers and sisters? The Lord said, maybe, oh, yes, you are already saved. I can bring you to heaven. But what about your brother? I love them also. I love them also. That's why I put you there, so that you can share the gospel. You can share with them your faith and be with us also. Amen? So we must put in our heart, in all our prayers, Lord, please give me even one soul in one day. If you cannot reach them personally, you share it by your cell phone or by the technology. I want to just one testimony. There is one lady in the internet. No, not a lady. He's a boy. He's a lady boy. Ano? A boy girl. So I don't know. So he looked like a man. Very, you know, handsome man. And but you know what? After hearing and hearing the word in the pag-aralan natin or kapitulo, versikulo or whatever, you know what? The picture was changed to a beautiful woman. And that lady said, thanks to God, I've been changed. Amen?
Amen.
So this is a very nice testimony. So I would like to end like this. May each and everyone put in our heart and in our mind that whatever God hath made, He loved it very much. Even us, if we love God, we must also love our neighbor. And that's the message. We must make the effort to bring them also to His kingdom. God bless you all. And happy Sabbath to each and every one.
Let us once again say amen for that message.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.